Hopefully next year she will try to make the Olympic team if the competition will, if she can make the Russian team. It's going to be very, very tough. So we will see, everybody, we will see what's going on right now with the Russian ladies, because they are so strong. It's an amazing amount of young girls, and every year the new ones are coming, and every year they are more impressive, and the technical level is so high that the top 10 of them, they can easily compete in the world level and challenge all the other skaters worldwide.
Yeah, it's amazing that the talent, ladies' talent in Russia right now. And we will see some of the juniors that were at the junior final try to make their mark, even though they are not eligible for the senior team. And we have quite a few contenders for that team. So right now in the first group is Yelena Radionova and Yevgenia Medvedeva, the world and European champion and Grand Prix final champion. And then also in that group we will see Alena Leonova.
She was silver medalist at World Championships in Nice,
yes,
in France.
In 2012. And she's, yeah, it's not easy for her, but she's still, she had a rough Grand Prix, but then she skated quite well at the Golden Spin in Zagreb. So let's see what she can do.
Yeah, but it's going to be tough for her.
Yeah, it's going to be tough for her to make the team, but at least to give two strong performances and prove that she's still there. So here's a young skater from St. Petersburg in the picture, Ekaterina Guseva, is training in Alexei Mishin school. Alek Tatourov, the main coach.
So we will see some new faces.
Yeah, that's always exciting. I haven't seen that girl, for example, yet. Ekaterina Guseva is 15 years old. Yeah, it's even difficult for Russian skaters to get onto the Junior Grand Prix, to get a spot on the Junior Grand Prix. You already need to be really good to get to the Junior Grand Prix.
I'm broadcasting on Facebook right now.
Ah, okay. Yeah. Live broadcast.
Live broadcast on Facebook.
Oh, we see. Isn't that Zeskanov? Former.
That's right. That's right. That's
competitor.
That's
he was tried quad lots. I remember him.
He was actually performing quad lots at the practices so many times. I'm not sure if he did it in the competition, but he was really
close,
one of the first
ones
who was doing the quad lots already about 7 years ago, six, 7 years ago.
Yeah, I know. I remember that he was trying it, but never was land cleanly enough in competition.
Well, of course, Evgenia Medvedeva, right now she is the best of the best in the world of figure skating. She won almost everything what she entered. She just completed the Grand Prix finals, of course, with a tremendous win. Before that she won two Grand Prix events, and now the Nationals, which is probably is toughest competition for her, because as I told you before, the level is so high.
And if you have any questions for us, you can you're very welcome to write us a message on Twitter to Archie19 or to Tatiana21.
Exactly.
we will watch the Twitter, and you can ask us, and we will try to find the answer if we don't know it.
I just would like to tell you how incredible the organization here is in Chelyabinsk. The organizing committee did an incredible, unbelievable work. I'm so impressed. I mean, the food everywhere, everything is clean, the security is very high. I mean, all the places, everything is done completely, professionally, wonderful. I mean, I have no more words like to express my feelings about the organization, because it's like a world championship. The level of the competition is so high, and as I tell you, told you, like if some of you watched the opening night last night of the opening ceremony, it was amazing opening ceremony with we had penguins on ice, as I mentioned before, like Pittsburgh Penguins team, hockey team in Pittsburgh, they used a couple of times, they used the penguins on their show opening, on their playoff games opening, but now we had those penguins also in the figure skating event in the opening ceremony. And it was interesting. They had like aerial acts with the juggling and the precision team. So everything was done very, very nice.
Yeah, and skaters and officials here have pointed out more than once that it was a better organization than the Grand Prix final 2 weeks ago in France.
Yeah, I was not there at Grand Prix final. But
yeah, it's about, you know, when the Russian organizing committee here, the people are trying really hard, they want to give their best, they want to make, they want welcome all athletes, spectators, officials, and they put a lot of effort into it.
Well, 1 minute left for till warm-ups will finished, and we will start. Our first skater will be Ekaterina Guseva. We don't know much about her. She's a fresh face and trains in St. Petersburg in a group of Oleg Tataurov. That's a skating school, actually. It's called Zvezdny Lyot, which is star ice, stars ice. It's a new club which is Alexei Mishin and Tamara Moskvina. They are the head of that Zvezdny Lyot club, so she represents that club. And her coach is Oleg Tataurov, but he's not here. So representing coach Sazonov, that we already mentioned before about him. And here we are going to start a ladies short program. Today, 23rd of December, city of Chelyabinsk. It's a 2 p.m. local time.
Yeah, so Ekaterina Guseva will be our first competitor. Pretty much exciting for her. It's the first time at the senior nationals. Last year she competed at I even looked at junior nationals. I'm just looking at her results.
And if you would like to watch us, as we said before, it's on ESPN, ESPN3. We are live. Triple toe and only double toe. I don't think will be any other girls going to do a triple-double combination. Most of them, they're going to perform all triple-triple combinations. And of course, she was trying to do triple-triple, but the second jump didn't go through. Triple flip with the arm up, gets the high, more difficulty, extra points. As you can see, it's 2 o'clock right now, and the arena is almost full.
Yeah, and this is a working day.
And it's a working day, and people work. They really do. But some of them, they find the time to come and see it, because that's how popular is figure skating in Russia.
Yeah, nice clean, but as you said already, not with the degree of difficulty needed to be competitive these days.
Anyway, it was her first event, first time she started competing at nationals, and it's so tough to skate first, so a lot of pressure, but she did pretty good, so welcome to nationals, Evgenia, Ekaterina Guseva.
So while she's getting off, already Yelena Radionova is on the ice, starting number two.
Very well-known skater, Yelena Radionova. She already have several big titles. She competed in all the major competitions. And she's only...
She's 17. She
17,
will be,
yeah.
She 17. Will be 18 in January.
Soon she will be... We cannot believe it. Only 17 years old, she already done so much. And of course, same coach, her longtime coach, Inna Goncharenko.
Yeah, and Yelena has been struggling a bit with growth. She's grown a lot, and also she had been a little bit sick in the fall and needed a long time to recover. But she is a true fighter. She is not going to give up. She is really tough.
Also, she was at finals for Grand Prix finals in Marseille, in France.
So the fourth consecutive time she made the senior final, and before that she was in the junior final. So it's really
very consistent. And the marks for Ekaterina Guseva coming out soon. Fifty-three point four. So that's the opening score for the competition. And on the ice, Yelena Radionova from Moscow. World silver medalist.
She was a world bronze medalist, two-time European silver medalist.
Music by George Gershwin. Misha G worked with her last year, this season actually. Incredible, talented Misha, very well known now. Triple lutz, triple toe. This program, I think, was done by Shailene Bourne, right?
Yes, this was by Shailene Bourne.
Yeah, Shailene Bourne from Canada. But that was a hard jump for her because I saw her, she was struggling in the track at the warm-up. She did beautiful, nice, and now she can enjoy and perform her program with all the flavor and the beautiful choreography by Shailene.
Yeah, well done, Yelena. I think that was the best trot program of the season that I've seen from her. She looked very solid. It's good to see she's getting into top shape when she really needs it. And you know the story about that dress, actually.
Tell me about it.
Yeah, that was a funny story. They had a totally different dress originally. And then she decided to surprise everybody with coming up with this dress. And she didn't even tell her coach. And then she suddenly showed up with that dress.
Oh, yeah?
Yes.
That happened today?
No, not today. That happened at the Cup of Russia Grand Prix.
Cup of Russia, okay. Because yeah. She skated on...
It's a very
sexy dress.
She used this dress all season now, but it was originally was a surprise for everybody. She had a... I even saw a picture of the original dress, which was more... reddish, but she said that she wanted to do something different, not the usual sequence. So that was a combination jump. Shows a replay. It's a little.
Well, let's see what the judge is gonna
say.
But probably, to me, it looks fine. Could be some questions, but still, in the favor of the skater, I don't see any problem.
She's always a good performer, Yelena. She likes to perform her program. So we see with her coaching staff. There's Inna Goncharenko on the right side.
70.19.
And Anna Bilibina, the choreographer, and Alexander Uspensky.
But now on the ice, the Yevgenia Medvedeva, European world champion, two-time Grand Prix champion.
Yeah, already a seasoned competitor, although she's still very young. Just turned 17.
Starting with flying combination spin.
Flying camel spin.
She has all major jumps on the second half of the program. Thank you. footwork sequence.
Easy.
Triple flip, triple toe combination. Triple loop. I like the way she picks up the speed after landing a jump. She gets really good speed. And a double axel with the arm up. Jumps are completed. Excellent. Clean.
Yeah, lovely.
Beautiful performance.
Lovely program by lovely Evgenia. There's a grandmother.
That's the grandma.
Yeah, grandma.
She's always supportive and...
I just met the grandma before the competition, and grandma told me that Evgenia didn't really want her to come to the Grand Prix final anymore. Because
why?
Evgenia thinks she's grown up now. Their grandmother is very happy.
Yeah, yeah.
But I told her that like some other skaters, like Brian Joubert, until the end of his career, he was traveling with his mom. So I think grandmother should be allowed to come, right?
Yes. No, I know her grandma. She's... lovely, lovely person, and she's very supportive, and of course she worries all the time, as every grandmother will do.
So she got a nice little present. Yeah, Evgenia very focused.
And I'm always going to tell that she is half Armenian.
And yet again, we don't have time now to go to the mix zone. It's so far away, but she will be hopefully, and should be at the press conference. She will probably again say that she still could do better than that. She is always very perfectionist and always believes she can improve something. And then she will say that maybe the jumps were good, but maybe the spins could have been faster, or there could be a stronger expression. She's always finding something to improve. I don't think it will be quite hard to top that, right?
I don't think anybody will top that. I also have red band on my wrist.
Is that something Armenian?
Actually, I got it from Jerusalem.
Gleichenhaus.
80.8. Huge marks.
Yeah, she already broke the record,
short
record, I mean internationally. Nationals you never can really count, but she broke the record for the short program at the Grand Prix final. And now she has like an unofficial record because it was 79.21 at the Grand Prix final. But now we have Serafima Sakhanovich
from St. Petersburg, now coached by Igor Evgeny Rukavitsin. Why I'm calling him Igor? Evgeny, of course. Evgeny Rukavitsin.
Yeah, Serafima has been struggling with puberty a bit this season.
Another story tell, short program. After Evgeny's story, flawless performance, now we will watch Serafima. She didn't go for a second triple jump, so she will try to attempt that in the next jump combination. So far only triple flip. But she has big jumps, fast spins. Of course, she grew now a beautiful young lady. When she was a kid, it was much easier for her. But now the body changed, and as you can see, it sometimes it's difficult for girls. But she came back and she's doing fine, and hopefully she will complete it fine this short program as well. Double. People love double talk.
Decided not to risk it.
Yeah. And the double axel. Played safe.
I enjoyed her performance, and it's good to see that she skated clean, even so she was not able to do her triple flip, triple toe as planned. But she held it together. And I think it's important for her to have skated a clean program. And we got a question, Ari.
Okay.
We got a question. And the question is from SMLW16. Do you think Julia Lipnitskaya will ever regain the form she showed in the last Olympic season?
Okay, should I answer?
Yes, go ahead.
I don't know.
Yeah, it's very, very tough. Because she showed a lot of improvement again. And then always was thrown back by injuries and strange things happening to her.
And of course, for her to see how strong the ladies are right now in Russia, it's also a lot of pressure going to competitions or having such a big title, Olympic title, and also world silver medal. And understanding that she goes and she has to compete with the girls, that they don't have that many titles, but they already are showing very difficult programs, and that's a lot of pressure. And she really tried. At the beginning of the season, she looked really good, but unfortunately, injuries. That's happening with any athlete, so we cannot say, you know, anything against her. That's life.
Yeah, well, just I think it depends. And if she can get really healthy again and keeps the motivation, then maybe she can come back. But it will be very hard, unfortunately.
But we will be, of course, happy to see her. She's a beautiful young lady, and her presence in any competition or show, it's always a big draw, and people love her. They would like to see her as many times she can make us happy with her performances.
And as long as she is happy.
She looked happy last year. She looked really happy with during the competition, the period of when she came to Cup of Russia.
Yeah,
she looked so happy, and she was training, and many of us looked at her Instagram, and she's active there. She shows that she's having a good time. With new coach Alexei Urmanov, very experienced coach, and he's of course 1994 Olympic champion from Lillehammer, and they live and train in Sochi, where the Olympic Games were held in 2014. The city has really become a sport capital in Russia. A lot of activities going on after the Olympics. All places where they had the Olympic Games, they're all active. 59.37, that's the score she got. And the third place so far. Next we have Valeria Mikhailova.
Yeah, from CSKA Moscow. She's with Sergei Davidov, a former international competitor and European silver medalist who represented Belarus later on, first Russia, then Belarus. She's 14 years old.
Triple flip, triple toe, no problems. Triple loop, and we have double axel left. And a double axel. Jumps are completed.
Thank you.
Good for her.
Yeah, that was nice. And then, oh, there's a choreographer was there as well. Sergei Verbilo, former Ukrainian ice dancer. Yeah, Vera was at the Junior Grand Prix last season with fourth and fifth place. This season that she didn't even get a Junior Grand Prix assignment.
Well, Sergei was a very good competitor. He's been there for so many years representing Belarus, and he was coached by legendary Elena Tchaikovskaya and Vladimir Kotin.
And he worked in Elena Tchaikovskaya's skating school then after his retirement. But now he's moved to CSKA Moscow, coaching there, and he took the student with him.
And the choreographer, he did that interesting program for Anna Pogorele when she was changing the costumes. I was actually quite pleased with that innovation of his, and the program looked good a couple of years ago.
Yeah, the Rise Like a Phoenix Conchita Wurst right. program.
That's right.
Yeah, it's pretty. Was something different. But Anna always, she has really her own mind and does her own things. So meanwhile, Alyona Leonova is on the ice.
Alyona Leonova also long time competitor. She's been on the limelight for several years. She had her ups and downs, but definitely she's a character and always performs with a lot of emotions. Meantime scores 59.90. That's third place so far.
Just edges out Serafima Zakhanovic. Yeah, Alyona Leonova. It's a very colorful look she has.
Her first coach, Alla Piatova, who always worries and always follows her student of her pioneer, and she's always nervous about it. But now she coached by Evgeny Rukavitsin for several years now. And as we can see, she's already in character. Beautiful triple toe combination. Covers a lot of ice.
Thank you.
That was the triple flip under rotated. Double coast and double axel. Also not a clean landing. Well, too bad. Such a fine girl, but she makes those mistakes. Unfortunately.
Yeah, a shame. A shame that she couldn't do a clean program. And there's no way she's going to be held up.
Yep. Now for her, she has to fight to get on the top 10.
Yeah, she seems in a good way because this is skating quite well in Zagreb. They're very disappointed.
She is disappointed. But look at her face. I mean, she's still, I mean, what a performer. With always puts a character with any performances she does in all her programs. She lives with those programs and delivers joy of the skating. And sometimes when she really does a good job, I mean, it's amazing to see what an energy she develops during the program.
Yeah, she's a flip. That's too bad.
Also, it was coached by Nikolai Morozov when she got silver medal at World Championships. Nikolai, who we all know, interesting person, and recently got married. His wife is competing here.
I will see her later today in the free dance.
Yes, tonight is the finals for the free dance coming up soon.
But yeah, Aliona, so do you think she will continue after that? If she's now going to be way down at nationals? Close to tears.
Disappointed. It's okay. There is always a long program, and she can try to improve.
Next group, we'll see Anastasia Gubanova, the silver medalist from the junior final. One of the youngsters we've been talking about.